Hi, I'm Adam Rombel, editor of the Central New York Business Journal here on February 13, with some thoughts on the current state of the national and local economy, specifically talking jobs. On February 3rd, the U.S. Bureau of Labor Statistics rolled out the latest jobs numbers nationally for January, and it was an unambiguously positive report across the board. The national unemployment rate fell to 8.3% from 8.5%. Payrolls increased by 243,000. The private payrolls jumped by 257,000. And if you look across industries, we had increases in employment basically in every industry. Let's run them down. Professional and business services, employment rose by 70,000. Manufacturing gained 50,000 jobs in January. Leisure and hospitality increased 44,000. Healthcare plus 31,000, and construction up 21,000. And then a few days later, on February 9, the Labor Department rolled out its unemployment first-time jobless claims data, and jobless claims fell again, and the four-week average declined to the lowest level in 4 years. So these back-to-back reports are showing that we have an improving job market, and the improvement has shown some acceleration in the last couple of months. However, even though there's some strong positives taking place, there are some negatives here, and there are some tales of caution to note as we move forward and what it might portend for the future. The caveats are these. Let's run them down. There's about five of them. First, that January employment report had a lot of seasonal factors, because the January report, the BLS has to adjust for the fact that a lot of seasonal jobs disappear following the holiday season and end of the year. So they have to do their best guess of what those adjustments should be. And that's all it is a guess. And when you look at the raw numbers, the number of people employed actually declined by 1.7 million. So to arrive at the increase of 243,000 in payrolls, the Labor Department had to basically estimate that the decline should have been 2 million. Also, population adjustments. The 2010 census data had to be incorporated into the latest numbers, and the BLS added 1.5 million people to the population. The problem is 1.25 million were not in the labor force. So we have the number of people not participating in the labor force is increasing. We've seen a steady increase in that, and it jumped by 1.2 million in January. And the labor force participation rate fell to 63.7%. from 64.0 in December. So that's, we're talking 30-year lows again. So these are definitely some disturbing trends taking place, that the number of people not participating in the job market keeps going up and the participation rate keeps going down. Furthermore, on February 2nd, we had a report from the New York State Comptroller about our situation here in New York, and it was a quite negative report. Comptroller Thomas DiNapoli said that our economic recovery in the Empire State may be slowing. He said that since July 2011, the state has lost 11,200 private sector jobs, and the acceleration in employment gains that we had seen the previous couple of years, where New York was actually doing better than the nation, has slowed, and we're now falling behind the national growth. He estimates that New York's gross domestic product will grow only 1.7% in 2012, lower than the projections of about 2% for the nation. Also, the average salary of jobs created in New York in the last couple of years is more than 40% lower than the average salary of jobs lost in that recession. And three upstate cities continue to lose jobs since the end of 2009. Binghamton lost 700 jobs, Ithaca shed 1,000, and Albany lost 1,700. So there are definitely some concerns on the state of the job market in New York. March 8 is when the New York Labor Department is going to report its January employment numbers. And ironically, this will actually come a few days after the USBLS reports the February numbers. So we have some catching up to do to take a look at what the latest numbers are from New York and juxtapose that against the national picture. But to recap, basically, we're seeing some positive signs of an improving job market nationally, but we have to look at some cautionary data on some disappointing labor force participation data and also some weakening of the momentum here in New York. But stay tuned till next month when I'll be back to comment on what the latest numbers show. Once again, I'm Adam Rombell with the Central New York Business Journal.